So we've had the likes of the 14-inch and the 16-inch MacBook Pro for a couple of weeks now. And one of the questions I keep getting asked is, what is battery life like with the M1 Pro and the M1 Max, and comparing that to the standard M1 chipset? Well, today we're going to do a comparison of the M1, M1 Pro and M1 Max in a battery drain test. Hi, it's Matt here. So that's right, today I'm going to be doing a battery drain test on these three MacBooks that you see right in front of me. Now, straight away, the first thing I want to say is, I've never actually ever done a battery test like this or a battery drain test like this. So this is an ultimate first for me. So, you know, maybe the video quality is not going to be the best of what you can find with other YouTubers out there who have done, like, say, iPhone battery drain tests. But I'm going to give it my best shot, and hopefully in the future, I can probably do a better job of it. But the main thing is, today, we've got these three MacBook Pros right in front of me, and we're going to do a battery drain test from 100% battery all the way down to 0%. Now, the three models that I have right in front of me, first of all, we have this one here, and it is a 13-inch MacBook Pro. Inside this, we have the standard M1 chipset with 8 GB of RAM. Then, moving on to this MacBook Pro here in the middle, this is the 14-inch MacBook Pro, and inside this, we have the M1 Pro inside it, and inside this, we have the kind of standard kind of M1 Pro chipset that was advertised by Apple. This is the 10-core model with the 16-core GPU inside. Yes, there is a baseline model of the 8-core, and also you can get, say, the 14-core GPU as the cheapest one, and I'll talk about that a little bit further on. But finally, what we have inside this MacBook Pro, the 16-inch one, we have the M1 Max inside this, and inside the M1 Max, we have the 32-core GPU, the standard 10-core CPU, what comes with all M1 Maxes, and also, at the same time, this is equipped with 32 GB of RAM. Now, one of the first questions you're probably going to ask is, well, these are not the baseline models. Yes, that is true. And also, these are not also the highest tier models. They're a bit of a mix. And I'm going to admit it is, to be honest, with this. But if you actually had a look on Apple's website, and in fact, if we actually picked all the different options out there, so say starting with the M1 MacBook Pro, there were two choices. You could pick the M1 chipset with 16 GB or 32 GB of RAM. Then you've got all the storage options. Then with this one here, the 14-inch MacBook Pro, you've got that 8-core M1 Pro, and you've also got that 14-core GPU. Then the next tier up is the same thing again with the 8 cores, and then you've also got the 16-core GPU. And then not alone, you can also pick between 16 GB of RAM, 32 GB of RAM. You could tick the 10-core option. You could also pick the option that has more CPU or GPU cores inside it. You could pick the M1 Max inside this with the 24 cores, the 32 cores. I could go on. In total, there's going to be 18 variants with all the different RAM options across all three of these models. And to be honest, I can't afford 18 models. So we've got these three models that you've got right here. But yeah, do check it out that there is actually 18 models you can pick from the M1 standard 13-inch all the way up to the maximum M1 Max with 64 GB of RAM inside it. So it's absolutely crazy. Lots of different options. But just to say again, we've got the M1 with 8 GB of RAM. We've got a 10-core M1 Pro with 16-core GPU with 16 GB of RAM. And then finally, what we have here is the M1 Max with 10-core CPU, 32-core GPU, and 32 GB of RAM. So enough rambling on about the specs of these different machines. What are the tests that we're going to do today? Well, today I'm going to chuck a load of kind of different type of tests out there for all three of these MacBook Pros. Some of these tests are going to be really, really light, like watching a Netflix video. And also some of them are going to be kind of medium sort of tasks. So in the sense of basically just doing a very small benchmark, or for example, just having a couple of basic apps open like Word, PowerPoint, a couple of Safari tasks open at one time. And some of them are going to be more extreme, like running a 3D benchmark on this. I'm going to try and spread it out the best I can. And like I said, this is the first time I'm doing this. So, you know, let me know in the comments below of what kind of other options you'd like to see, maybe in future videos when I do battery drain tests. But just to let you guys know, I have set all of these MacBook Pros at 85% screen brightness, and I've done that using our favorite S-Lady or S-Man. I'm not going to say it because I'll probably trigger all your phones and trigger all these MacBook Pros off. So I've done that, and I've also set the same setting for the sound to all be at 85%. Now, 85% might be a little bit more higher than usual, but to be deadly honest, I thought this would be a best good benchmark to get these kind of gauges on for all three of these MacBook Pros. And plus, it's easier for you guys to see what's going on these actual screens with the camera that I'm using right here. So without further ado, let's get started with the test. And basically, all these three of these MacBook Pros are all going to be charged up to 100%, what I'm going to show you. And we're going to basically do kind of a time lapse or speed run through all the tests. And I'm also going to time how long these MacBook Pros take to drain from 100% to zero. So on the very left, we have the MacBook Pro with the M1. In the middle, we have the 14-inch MacBook Pro, and this one has the M1 Pro inside it. And then on the far right, we have the 16-inch MacBook Pro, and this inside it has that M1 Max chipset. So I've got Final Cut Pro open. And today I'm going to be exporting a 1 hour video in H.264.4, and this is on the YouTube setting built into Final Cut Pro. What I've done is I've looped my Windows 11 video, this is on my channel at the moment, up to 1 hour long, and we're going to start this off. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to start all these MacBook Pros off by doing the export and start the timer there. That's on an iPhone XR that I have. And we're going to get this beginning and we're going to leave this run. So we're going to see how long it takes to export on this. So most likely, I'm quite confident that the 16-inch MacBook Pro with that M1 Max chipset inside it is probably going to finish off first. Then most likely, I'm going to say my money is on the M1 Pro. And then after this, my money is on that 13-inch MacBook Pro. So I'm going to let this run now and I'm going to speed up a little bit to see which ends first. And sure enough, the first actual MacBook Pro to finish the full export is the M1 Max, followed by the M1 Pro, and then finally by the M1 MacBook Pro. So let's check out the actual battery at this point. So the 16-inch MacBook Pro has a battery of 92%, then the 14-inch MacBook Pro has a battery of 89%, and then finally the 13-inch M1 MacBook Pro has a battery of 77%. So next of all, after doing this, I'm just going to close down Final Cut Pro on these machines. I'm actually going to run some benchmarks tests on these machines. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to run Geekbench 5 first of all, and we're going to do a single core, multi-core kind of test on this. So I'm just going to get this started in all three of the machines at the same time. Let me just get those all open and we're going to begin that. And then after this, we're going to do a Cinebench benchmark on the single core and also the multi-core. And then finally, I'm going to run another Geekbench benchmark again. And this is going to be for the actual compute score, the Metal compute score. So I'm just going to get these started on all three of these machines. So that was the first Geekbench just completed. So I'm just running now the Cinebench, and this is on the single core to begin with. And we'll let this just run. And now that's completed, I'm going to start the multi-core next of all. When that is complete as well, this should be a little bit more quicker. Now that's completed, I'm going back to Geekbench again. And this time I'm going to run the compute score on Metal and let that complete. And now that is all completed, let's now check out what the battery life is like. So on the 16-inch MacBook Pro, the battery is coming in at 77%. On the 14-inch MacBook Pro, it's at 70%. And then the 13-inch MacBook Pro, it's now at 62%. So the next test I'm going to do is I'm going to open up the likes of Word, PowerPoint. I'm also going to open up Safari, and I'm going to open up five different tabs all at the same time. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave this run for an hour, because I know a lot of you guys out there, for example, do a lot of sort of word processing, presentations, browsing the internet all at the same time. So this will be a good test to see how well the batteries cope with this. So I'm just going to get everything open on these three machines and then basically let it all run for 1 hour, and we'll see what the results are with the battery after this. So while this battery drain test is continuing on, I thought today I would talk about the giveaway that we're doing on this channel, and it is for this. It is for an iPhone 13 Pro Max Sierra Blue 128GB model. And I'm going to be giving it away to one lucky subscriber when we get over 300,000 subscribers. And to be honest, it's not that far away. Now, to enter into this giveaway, what is an international giveaway, All I'd love to know from you guys in the comments below is what Apple gear are you planning to buy in the next year or so? Or what technology gear you're planning to buy in the next year or so? Write it down in the comments below. And also at the same time, make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell, because when we get over that 300,000 subscribers, I'm going to be making a video announcing who the winner is of this iPhone 13 Pro Max. And you don't want to miss that notification for that video. Also, at the same time, guys, I must just comment now. Unfortunately, like a lot of other YouTubers out there, there's a lot of scammers and spammers who are basically impersonating us by putting our profile pictures and things and basically saying, you've won a prize. This is not me at all. And lots of their names are very similar to mine, or they're saying, what's at me? This is not me. Like I said, what I will be doing, I'll be announcing the winner via a video. Well, guys, let's get back to the battery drain test. So after an hour running this test, and we're now at over 2 hours 20 minutes into all of this drain test, we now have the battery results. So with the 16 inch MacBook Pro, it's at 68% battery, the 14 inch is just behind this at 59%, and then the 13 inch is just behind that at 54% battery. So with this out of the way, what I decided to do was run my next test. Now my next test is actually running a Netflix video, or actually a movie, and that movie is of our favorite sponge who lives under the sea with his best friend of a starfish. So I decided to run the first movie of this, and this clocks up a total of 1 hour 28 minutes, so basically an hour and a half. So let this run on all three of the MacBook Pros. I decided this was a fair test because a lot of you guys out there use your MacBook Pros to watch videos, like for example watching your favorite YouTuber on YouTube. And that's a massive hint that if you're enjoying this video so far, please do press the like button. So by the time this video had finished, we were just under 4 hours into our test, and the results are like this at the moment. So with the actual 16 inch MacBook Pro, the actual battery is at 53%. With the 14 inch MacBook Pro with that M1 Pro chipset inside it, we're at 43%. And then the 13 inch MacBook Pro with that M1 chipset inside it is at 39%. So after this, I decided that I would do my next test. And to be honest, this is the last test I'm going to run. I decided that I was going to run Unigen Heaven on this, and this is another 3D benchmarking test, and I'm going to run this all the way until the MacBook Pros basically completely deplete or drain their battery to 0%. Now I could run multiple games on these MacBook Pros, but I decided to do a benchmarking test instead. Mainly the reason is because if you've got a Steam account, for example, that you can't actually play the same game at the same time on all three of these models unless you've got three separate accounts. It just won't allow you to do it. It just does remote play. So I decided this was probably the best way to do it, was actually run the same sort of loop of a 3D engine, and then basically we would get the same results, because playing a game, you play it very differently on each level, even though if you tried your best to keep to the same sort of measures. So after this, I ran this all the way up to 4 hours 50 minutes, because I had a feeling that some of these batteries are probably going to die around about 5 hours, possibly. So I let it run up to this, and then I did a battery check. So at this point here, the 16-inch MacBook Pro only had 20% battery left, and then the 14-inch MacBook Pro only had 4% battery left. It was on its last legs. And then also the 13 inch MacBook Pro is just behind that with 9% battery. So I let this continue run on for a little bit further to see if one of the actual models would die out. But then I spoke too soon, and sure enough, the 14 inch MacBook Pro, after a total of 4 hours 51 minutes, it actually did die. And that was a really, really good run from this MacBook Pro. Based on knowing that the 13 inch MacBook Pro with that M1 chipset wasn't far behind, I ran this up to 5 hours to see if the battery would die at this point. And luckily, the MacBook Pro did manage to get over the actual 5 hour mark. So that is really, really impressive. But very, very shortly after this time, I am sad to say that the 13 inch MacBook Pro tried its ultimate best and decided to shut down. But it's super impressive to get a 5 hour, 1 minute, or almost 2 minutes battery life out of this MacBook Pro. So, with one MacBook Pro left standing, I decided to check the battery on the 16-inch MacBook Pro, and at this point, it was at 9% battery. So its juice was running out as well, but it was doing a very, very good run. So, speeding up this video, let's see when it died. So, it finally gave us its end of battery life at a grand total of 5 hours and 16 minutes and 15 seconds, what is really, really impressive. So yeah, that was all three of the MacBook Pro's batteries depleted from 100% all the way down to 0% in doing a load of different tests. So the end results were this. The 14-inch MacBook Pro came in at a total of 4 hours 51 minutes, and just shortly after that was the 13-inch MacBook Pro at 5 hours and 1 minute. Finally, we had the 16-inch MacBook Pro with that M1 Max chipset inside it at 5 hours 16 minutes. So as you can see, that test took a long time, and to be honest, I was up beyond midnight doing these tests on these MacBook Pros. But the results are very, very clear. The M1 MacBook Pro definitely has a really, really good battery in it, and it came ahead of this 14-inch MacBook Pro that we have right here, only running about 10 minutes or so, so it's not that much in it. And remember, this is the 10-core CPU what's inside this MacBook Pro. But, you know, in comparison of battery life, they are very, very similar. And then not long after, it wasn't that far after, I think it was about 15 minutes later, after the M1 had died, it was when the M1 Max 16-inch had died. Basically, all three models died their battery life within around half an hour of each other in total. So really, no matter what MacBook you're going to pick, you're going to get around the same sort of battery life if you did the kind of same test that I did here. Now again, I could say, you could argue that my test could be unfair, they're not real life, but it was the best test I could think of off the spot. And like I said, write down in the comments below if you think of any other tests. But my end conclusion is this. I don't think you can go wrong with whatever MacBook you pick. Like I said, they all finish within half an hour of each other, what's absolutely amazing. And to be deadly honest, if you did say some more lighter tasks, say on all three of these machines, maybe this MacBook Pro would have come first. And maybe, for example, these two MacBook Pros would have died far sooner. I know this one did, but like I said, they could have died maybe an hour before that because they've got less efficiency cores. So you have got that. Plus, also, it could be the other way around. If you were doing loads of sort of 3D kind of rendering and kind of loads of bits and pieces like this, maybe these two MacBook Pros would have died before this one here. But the end conclusion, like I said, there's not much in it. So you can't go wrong in whatever MacBook Pro that you pick after seeing this battery drain test. Well guys, it's also time to wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press that like button because I really appreciate it. And also at the same time as well, if you want the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons like this, please also make sure you hit that subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, I will see you really soon. Bye bye.